Morning, everybody. Good to see everyone here this morning, and I mean that literally. Were you affected by that power outage yesterday? Well, yesterday afternoon we had another power outage, and I was afraid we were going to have to say mass by candlelight, but thank God and the electric company, the power came back on at almost exactly 4 o'clock, so we were good to go. Just as always, do please take a copy of the bulletin home with you, lots of good information in there. There's an insert from the Knights of Columbus with some upcoming Knights of Columbus initiatives, including promotion of the Rosary, pancake breakfast, and some others, so please do read that. Of course, next weekend is Super Bowl Sunday, which means Super Bowl Mania here at St. Boniface. Information about that event is in the bulletin. We hope to see you there. For our First Reconciliation families, there will be a First Reconciliation retreat next Saturday at Our Lady of Mount Carmel. Please check the bulletin for information about that. As we mentioned last weekend, we are again doing the College Care Package program for the young people from our parish who are enrolled in college. We are asking this time if you have empty Pringles containers, don't throw those away, please bring those. We're going to use those as the shipping containers for this initiative. So if you have empty Pringles containers, clean them out first, please, but please bring those and we'll use those for the College Care Packages. And then again, available in the gathering space this weekend, we have copies of the parish's 2016 annual report. We have copies of information about the Allgaier scholarships. We have your 2016 contribution statements for tax purposes. We also have a copy of the preliminary parish pastoral plan. We're asking you to please take that and read it over and prayerfully respond with the feedback form that is also available there. So all of that, again, available in the gathering space after Mass. In our entrance antiphon found on page 62 in the Breaking Bread, page 62 in the Breaking Bread. Save us, O Lord our God, and gather us from the nations to give thanks to your holy name and make it our glory to praise you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words and what I've done and what I've failed to do through my fault.
through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Please join me in reciting the Gloria. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit, the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Grant us, O Lord our God, that we may honor you with all our mind and love everyone in truth of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zephaniah. Seek the Lord, all you humble of the earth, who have observed his law. Seek justice, seek humility. Perhaps you may be sheltered on the day of the Lord's anger. But I will leave as a remnant in your midst a people humble and lowly, who shall take refuge in the name of the Lord, the remnant of Israel. They shall do no wrong and speak no lies, nor shall there be found in their mouths a deceitful tongue. They shall pasture and couch their flocks with none to disturb them. The word of the Lord. Our response, blessed are the poor in spirit, the kingdom of heaven is theirs. The Lord keeps faith forever, secures justice for the oppressed, gives food to the hungry. The Lord sets captives free. The Lord gives sight to the blind. The Lord raises up those who were bowed down. The Lord loves the just. The Lord protects strangers. The fatherless and the widow the Lord sustains, but the way of the wicked he thwarts. The Lord shall reign forever, your God, O Zion, through all generations. Alleluia. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Consider your own calling, brothers and sisters. Not many of you were wise by human standards. Not many were powerful. Not many were of noble birth. Rather, God chose the foolish of the world to shame the wise, and God chose the weak of the world to shame the strong. And God chose the lowly and despised of the world, those who count for nothing, to reduce to nothing those who were something, so that no human being might boast before God. It is due to him that you are in Christ Jesus, who became for us wisdom from God, as well as righteousness, sanctification, and redemption, so that, as it is written, whoever boasts should boast in the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. The Lord be with you.
A
reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain. And after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. I am a product of the Pennsylvania public school system. I sometimes joke with people that the first Catholic school I ever attended was the seminary, but it's true. Growing up near Meadville, I attended Segertown schools and graduated valedictorian of my class. Moving on to Gannon University, while at the same time attending St. Mark's Seminary, right here in Erie, I earned a 3.98 GPA. And graduated summa cum laude with a BA in philosophy. Next stop was St. Mary's Seminary in Baltimore, where I earned my first master's degree and graduated near the top of my class, earning the highest marks in my class on our 4-year comprehensive exams. I'm not telling you these things to brag or to make myself look good. I'm telling you to make a point. Public education prepared me well to succeed in life. But today, as we begin our annual celebration of Catholic Schools Week, I stand here before you strongly in support of Catholic education. I do so very much aware of the pain and loss that many of our people are experiencing as we prepare to close our own parish school. Although our parish school is closing, I also stand here today to state unequivocally that our parish remains committed to supporting Catholic education and promoting its importance in the lives of our people. It's no secret that there's a certain amount of tension in our area between families who send their children to public schools and families who send their children to Catholic schools. That tension often leads to unhealthy competition and slanted comparisons, with families each trying to somehow prove that their school is better. Not being a parent and having experienced in different ways both public and Catholic education, I'm able to step back and see things from a different angle. And from where I stand, I see little or no difference in the academic opportunities offered by the different kinds of schools. As always, it is up to the individual student and his or her parents to take advantage of those opportunities, whatever school you attend. But the opportunities themselves are pretty much the same. So why support Catholic education? I said that the academic opportunities are the same, but there are other differences. Public schools can offer some things that, for a variety of reasons, Catholic schools cannot. But Catholic schools offer other things that public schools cannot. And at least one of those things offered by Catholic schools for Catholics makes all the difference. Catholic schools offer Christ. In the Gospels, we see Christ doing many things: healing, exorcisms, miracles, even rising from the dead. But one thing he does more than any other is teach. Christ is our teacher, as we see in today's gospel, gathering his disciples around him and teaching them the deeper truths of life that the world does not understand and can never teach. Christ the teacher lives and continues to teach his disciples today within the walls of our Catholic schools. In the classroom, as students learn how the creation stories of Genesis and theories of evolution can coexist. In the gym, as basketball players bow their heads together in prayer. In school masses, where Christ comes to our young people, body, blood, soul, and divinity in the Eucharist. There are differences between public and Catholic schools, and the biggest difference is Christ. Now, does that mean that parents who send their children to public schools are in some way depriving their children of Christ? Absolutely not. But it does mean that they are potentially making their job as Catholic parents to raise their children in the faith more difficult. Public schools are at best indifferent to the religious faith of their students. They do not support the faith you as parents teach your children in the home, and may even at times oppose it. An example from my own public education came during a high school health class. We were studying a unit on HIV, and to my school's credit, we were taught that abstinence is an effective way of avoiding this disease. But in the very next breath, we were also taught how to use artificial contraception, a position clearly against what we believe as Catholics. It is in moments like that where we see the value of a Catholic education, a school system that fully supports and builds up the faith you as parents teach your children in the home. Is it necessary to send your children to Catholic school to raise them to be faithful Catholics? Again, of course not. Nor is sending your children to Catholic schools a guarantee of that either. But it certainly can help. And in our day, in these increasingly troubled times, Catholic parents can use all the help that they can get. I am proud to be an alum of Segertown Schools and grateful for the education I received there. But I am also proud to support Catholic education. I'm not telling anyone here not to send your children to public school. I am inviting and even challenging the parents here today to prayerfully consider sending your children to Catholic schools. May Christ, our greatest teacher, guide your decisions, and may he help you in every way to raise your children in the faith. Please stand. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Gathering our prayers together, we offer them to our Heavenly Father, who we know hears us and answers us.
Our response is, Jesus, hear our prayer. Called to be a light to the nations, may we ask for God's justice, peace, and healing. Let us pray.
Jesus, hear our prayer.
Holy God, tear down divisions and unite the church universal in your mission. Let us pray.
Jesus, hear our prayer.
You call us to care for creation. Breathe into us the joy and beauty of stewardship. Teach us to care for the small seed and the expansive sky. Let us pray.
Jesus, hear our prayer.
Bring an end to tyranny and poverty. Wipe out fear. Uphold all your children who suffer in body, mind, and spirit. Let us pray.
Jesus, hear our prayer.
Ever-living God, you call us to rest in you. Keep us faithful on earth and bring us to life everlasting with the saints of every time and place. Let us pray.
Jesus, hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son, especially all living and deceased members of St. Boniface Parish, for whom this Mass is offered. Let us pray.
Jesus, hear our prayer.
For all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, let us pray.
Jesus, hear our prayer.
As many of our diocesan brothers and sisters traveled to Washington this past week in support of life, we offer a prayer as well today for the protection and respect of all human life from conception to natural death. We pray to the Lord.
Jesus, hear our prayer.
We conclude our prayers of the faithful by praying together our St. Boniface prayer, asking for God's continued guidance on our parish planning. Pray together,
Eternal God, the refuge and help of all your children. We praise you for all you have given us, for all you have done for us, for all that you are to us. In our weakness you are strength, in our darkness you are light, in our sorrow you are comfort and peace. We cannot number your blessings, we cannot declare your love. For all your blessings we bless you. May we live as in your presence and love the things that you love and serve you in our daily lives.
Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you,
fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O Lord, we bring to your altar these offerings of our service. Be pleased to receive them, we pray, and transform them into the sacrament of our redemption, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O Lord, be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most holy, to your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Lawrence, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. God. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my life, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Nourished by these redeeming gifts, we pray, O Lord, that through this help to eternal salvation, true faith may ever increase, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I ask you to please be seated for a moment. The Knights of Columbus have a presentation they'd like to offer. Congratulations, Knights. Keep up the great work. Please stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.